Today we're taking a look at the most anticipated tech of the year, the Xbox Series X and the PlayStation 5. Keep in mind that this video will not be going over tech specs of the systems. You've likely already read or heard all about the teraflops and how fast you'll be able to feel like Spider-Man with the new SSDs. Instead, we'll be comparing the everyday gaming experience on two of the same LG CX 55-inch OLED TVs. If you're interested in this TV for your next-gen system, be sure to check out our next video where we'll be reviewing it. Also, we'll be giving away a PS5 and a Series X. Watch till the end for how to win. If you are curious about the specs of these systems, feel free to pause the video now. Otherwise, let's get into it. First things first, the design. It's no secret that the PS5 is a beefcake, especially comparing it to its predecessor. The Series X also went bigger in size for the new generation, but Microsoft managed to fit its specs in a much smaller size. Though, despite being smaller, the Xbox is nothing special to look at and could even be confused as an air purifier. Just remember, it won't purify your vape smoke. Despite PlayStation's sleek look, the size can get problematic, depending on your entertainment setup. We brought it home to test it in our TV stand, and this monster is almost as tall as the stand itself, and sadly there is no perfect place for it. Although it fits in the main console nook, we're definitely dealing with limited airflow here, which is not super ideal. In comparison, the Series X fits comfortably in a similar design TV stand. Looking at the controllers, this is where PlayStation shines. The DualSense is now slightly larger with a bigger touchpad and a redesigned adaptive system. The triggers now have haptic, resistive feedback based on what you are using in-game. We expect that future games will be using this immersive feature in a variety of creative ways. The Xbox controller, on the other hand, hasn't been noticeably updated. It now has a capture button, a nice add, but a long-awaited feature, and it also still runs on AA batteries. But the new controller does make minor improvements to an already loved controller, including an even more comfortable grip, texture on the triggers, an improved D-pad, and an overall matte finish. Now for the essentials, the games. While both systems will see the usual lot of great releases on both platforms, exclusivity has always been a touchy subject for gamers. Xbox will always have Halo, though lately PlayStation has been dominating with blockbuster hits like Last of Us Part 2, Ghost of Tsushima, God of War, Horizon, some of which we're anticipating major sequels for. Otherwise, there's also this Love, Death, and Robots looking game where you get to play as a cat. Sign me up. With that said, Microsoft has been actively spending big money in acquisitions to give a boost to studios working under their wing. Just back in September, Microsoft spent a whopping $7.5 billion to acquire ZeniMax Media, parent company of these little game studios. Xbox also has the Game Pass, and with the Xbox Series X, you have access to the entire backlog of games from day one, even games from the original Xbox. While the PlayStation does have backwards compatibility for a majority of titles from the PS4 era, currently you don't have access to older games from previous generations. Sony also introduced their own version of Game Pass as a new addition for PS Plus subscribers. The PlayStation Collection includes a bunch of major exclusives at no extra cost to your current subscription. What about storing all these games? The PS5 comes with an internal SSD storage of 825 GB, while the Series X comes with a terabyte internal SSD. Keep in mind, these numbers don't represent usable storage. After the installation of basic software, the PS5 maxes out at only 667 gigabytes of usable storage, while the Xbox maxes out at 802 gigabytes. This is a big deal, especially when certain games are massive whales that take up a third of our entire system. The Series X has a super simple feature to expand the storage, but it comes at a premium. For $220, you can buy this 1 TB Seagate SSD that easily inserts into the back of the system like any memory card would. It's a great design feature, but when your console is $499, are you really looking to spend almost half the price of another system to boost your storage? Down the line, these will of course get cheaper. The PS5 has a tough time comparing at launch. The PlayStation does have a slot to expand the internal storage, but support for it is currently not available. Sony has confirmed that there will be a post-launch update, and the delay is caused by them just trying to find a good enough SSD that can handle the speed. Though, once that drive does exist, you will still need to pop off the PS5 cover and unscrew a plate just to get to that available slot. With both consoles, you can still use USB external storage to get access to older generation titles. Though, you will not be able to install PS5 or Series X or S games onto the external hard drive to expand your storage or play on other systems. Quite simply, even your super fast external SSD will not be able to handle the bandwidth that next-gen gaming needs to perform at. Overall, both these systems are extremely powerful and will be delivering some mind-boggling experiences over the next handful of years. Looking at the graphics, we put the consoles side by side on the same LG CX 55-inch OLED, with both TVs set with the same picture settings and loaded with the new Call of Duty Cold War to see how it performs. To the naked eye, the graphics seem identical, and most people wouldn't be able to tell the difference between the two. So, which one is better? We don't think either system is better than the other. Both systems have things that we love and hate. The Xbox Series X is a more powerful, faster system, but we also prefer the exclusives that PlayStation Studios have brought and have on the horizon. Though, if you've always been a fan of the Xbox Game Collection, you'll have a much better access to that on day one. The likely scenario is that if you are already in one ecosystem or the other, you're likely going to stick with upgrading to your next generation console. We're excited to see what these systems are actually capable of once developers are releasing truly next-gen games. If you weren't able to get your hands on either of these systems, before you go out and spend over $1,000 on eBay, we have an extra PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X to give away. To enter, make sure you subscribe and check the description for more instructions. Next, we'll be reviewing this LG 55-inch OLED 4K TV to figure out if this is the best TV for next-gen gaming.